I'm here with Erin Gerlach, and she has a great idea for transforming picture frames into serving trays.
That's right, Julie.
It's super cool, and they're absolutely beautiful and totally custom, and you have promised me that this is unbelievably easy.
It is pretty easy.
Okay, let's do it.
So you want to pick a frame that's wood, solid, that's a good find. A thrift store is a great place to find these. And you're going to start by taking the backer off of it.
Okay.
And making sure that the glass doesn't interfere with the outside of the frame, because you're going to want to drill through it to put handles in it when you're all done with this. So this we're going to leave the glass in, but if it's chintzy or a broken glass, obviously you want to remove that.
Can I take this out of the way for you?
Yes, you can, please. So you're going to start by taping the frame off because you don't want to grout over the wood.
And you're using a painter's tape, obviously, which means it will remove easily from that wood and not harm it in any way.
Correct. And then we're gonna use a two-part synthetic modeling clay.
Okay, and I'll mix that for
you. And you're gonna mix that, no marbling.
It remains soft until the two parts come together, right? And it is the mixing of the two that causes that to then harden.
And heat activates.
Okay.
Yes, heat is good.
So how do I know when I'm done with this?
It's gonna be uniform color. There's gonna be no streaking.
So like the one that you're using. So I'm just mixing up the same thing that you're using there, since yours is all the way mixed.
Right. And I'm just gonna work in stages a little bit because I think that that's easy. Personally, I like to do things that way.
I think sometimes when you grab a littler piece, it just means that you are able to smooth it, even though it seems like it would be quicker to just sort of smash the whole big ball onto there.
Exactly.
And I notice you even roll it out into a snake so that it's kind of the right length and it's not too deep and you're just not having to work quite as hard.
Exactly. So then I'm going to start laying my tiles in, which I put in a pattern ahead of time because it's
so
just
easy. So if you're a planner,
you
can actually plan this out quite a bit.
Yes. And it's helpful.
Now, can you use any kind of tile, or does it have to be like ceramic or glass or something
specific? Any kind of tile. Okay. Any kind of tile works. I like things that are just a little bit thicker. If you get too thin of a tile, it's hard to grout it.
Okay.
At least with this. And so we're just tootsie rolling this in here just like that.
And that just means you're putting a little snake between it to sort of be that squishy grout part.
So then when you go to the next layer, you're gonna do like a whole tootsie roll.
A long
roll there.
Snake.
Yep, you're just gonna be done with it. And then that's when I'm seating them in here. And you wanna peel the backer off of them. You know, like some of them have backers on them.
Right, like
still.
A big mesh backing. And do they just pop right off, or do you have to use scissors?
You just pull them right off.
Oh, well, that makes me fearful for the tile in my bathroom, knowing you can just pop it
Well, that's why you grout it, Julie. That's why you grout
it. So I noticed you actually added that little snake after you had the tile down, and that's fine too.
Correct. Yep, you can just kind of go as you like.
So you can do it really however you want to do it.
Yep.
You know, that's so fun, Erin, and I find, like, you know, I love it when you bring a project that allows forgiveness, that allows for mistakes, that allows for beginners.
But it's not going to look like a beginner's project when we're all done with
this. That's the coolest part. Those are my favorites, when it looks like you are a professional, and yet you're just trying it for, you know, out.
Right.
Now, I know that normally you would have, you know, clay completely under here to get it done. You wouldn't actually have the glass showing like that.
Correct. So we're going to go right to grouting then. And so I'm just using water for this. Well, you know, to be exact, because it's a serving tray, you want it level. You can even get real technical with an actual level.
So if this were like gonna be a mirror that were going on the wall, or even if you actually were doing
this
on the wall, right? You wouldn't have to do necessarily the rolling because it wouldn't matter if it was totally level. But because people might actually put drinks and a cheese plate or whatever else you want on it, especially wine glasses, I know I tip those over anyway.
Right, so then you're gonna start grouting it. And it takes a little effort to
a little elbow grease behind there. And all you're doing when you say grouting is you're just trying to get the clay off the tops of the tiles.
Yes.
Now, is there any way that the water is harming the clay, or you have to be careful about not using too much water? Like, could you use a spritz bottle of water, or would that be too much water?
No, a spritz bottle would work great. It would work great. And so you want to just keep working the clay until you're really happy with how the tiles look. And you can get them very, very clean, and I really like to clean them up with a solvent.
Okay.
Is the best way to
really get them beautifully clean.
Yep.
Because if you see anything on there, I assume that is permanent forever on there.
Right. So it just cleans them up really really good, and then you can.
Now we're using white, but could you color this with paint, or does it come in other colors? Like, how do you?
You could do that. Okay. It comes in a lot of different colors. So we're gonna skip over then to this tray here.
Okay.
Where it's all done, and there's this center piece already done, and this is already cured. So that's the nice part. You can work in stages.
So you can come back the next day, a week later, tomorrow morning, and
mm-hmm. finish it, or wake up in the middle of the night, like I do sometimes, and people find you randomly in your workspace.
I've been known to do that myself. You know, you never know when the creative urge will strike you.
Right, right. So then you can just use a little water to smooth it, and it really puts a
nice edge
there. And then we're gonna get really fun, and we're gonna put some crushed glass. This is just crushed glass in here. And then we'll use a clear resin.
Now, do you have to wait for the clay to cure before you pour the resin?
No, you do not. I've done it both ways. And the clay, because it's like a, it's a two-part, it's like the chemical reaction type of thing. Okay. It's gonna cure no matter what. You're gonna take a clear resin and equal parts A and B.
So this is the same as the clay, right? Where it doesn't harden until you mix both parts together.
It's the same concept. Okay. So you're gonna mix this one very, 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 very slowly.
Why?
Because it creates bubbles otherwise, and then you'll end up with them in your finished piece. So then you'll take your clear resin and you'll just drizzle it and pour it as you like over the top.
So cool. And is it self-leveling, so you don't have to worry?
It is self-leveling, but you don't want to touch it after you pour it. That's where using, again, a solvent is really helpful, because if it spills out on the tiles, you can clean it up quickly like that, and you can actually, you know, like, just push it around just like that a little bit until you're happy with it.
So you definitely want to do this on a surface where you can let it sit like overnight.
Absolutely.
Okay,
absolutely.
So how long should we expect until it's hard to the touch?
Just the next day.
Okay.
The next day, but you should really wait like 48 hours before you actually really use it.
Before you actually put your cheese on that.
Yes, yes, yes.
So if we look at some of the finished ones, I can see right here how that resin, I mean, it's amazing what's caught in there. The tile is so beautiful, and I can't believe this was a picture frame. What about the handles?
The handles are just from a hardware store, but you could go over with clay on the handles if you wanted to, you know, kind of sculpt with it, because you can do that with it, and there's a piece down there that has a red W in it, and that's all hand sculpted.
So the red W, which you were just talking about, you just hand sculpted that, and you told me those are bottle caps.
Yeah, it's a great way to use clear resin as bottle caps and just make it something different than the crushed glass. You could use anything under there, crystals.
What about this yellow one?
That is a beehive. Kind
so
of a
cute.
Style. And you can really get crazy with how you lay out the tiles and just kind of keep smoothing them as you go. And then make different channels in there.
So you can really be unbelievably creative. You could have the same picture frame, but never have the same serving tray.
Absolutely. You can even finish the frame differently if you like, before or after. That's
so you could take helpful. Your frame, paint it, stencil on it, any of that kind of stuff, and make it really custom from the very beginning.
You could. You could. Just cover it with the tape.
This is such a cool project, Erin.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you. It was fun.